high above Pakistan's fabled mountains, Imran Khan, former international cricket star, now the country's fastest rising politician, is on the campaign trail. Elections are just weeks away, May 11th. We've just landed in Swat. It's about 50 minutes helicopter ride, about 4 hours drive from the capital, Islamabad. A few years ago, this area was overrun by the Taliban. Khan's security is going to be a concern here. Armored car, high-speed convoy, soldiers line the road. It's the new normal for Khan, an ascendancy that has seen him turn his tiny Movement for Justice party, with just one parliamentary seat, into a national party capable of breaking the political status quo, winning dozens, possibly scores of seats from the established parties.
There are tens of thousands of people here, a huge number in this mountainous region. Khan is the upstart candidate. He wants to use his charisma to change these people, to move them, get them to believe that they vote for him, they vote for change, they vote for something different.
There is only one way to win it, and that is to have a public movement against the old political houses, the old political parties.
And that's part of his pull here. Most view him as a rarity, an uncorrupted politician.
Khan's got a tough political battle on his hand. The two big political parties here have been in power for decades. They're rich. They've got the support of hundreds of thousands, millions of people across the country. And they look at Khan, they say he's politically inexperienced, politically inept.
Yet Khan has broad appeal. Rural conservatives here, he advocates talking to the Taliban.
The key to peace in Pakistan lies through the tribal area people.
He also won over many of the young, urban, educated middle class and is reputed to have more Twitter followers than any other Pakistani politician. If his party wins enough votes to form a government, and right now that is still a very long shot, he vows to do what he says other politicians have not and look out for the poor.
Khan has no problem getting the numbers out to come and watch. No problem at all getting them excited. But the real challenge is going to be, come May the 11th, getting them to turn out and vote for him, break with their past. Nick Robertson, CNN, the Swat Valley, Pakistan.